Hello and welcome to follow my video course Introduction to Flow Mechanics. My name is Matti Ylitalo and I'm your teacher during this course. In this video our focus will be on fins. Fins are typically used to increase the surface area for heat transfer. There are a lot of cases in industry where we use fins to increase heat transfer. On the left you see a typical heat transfer unit used, for example, when we have airflow in duct and we want to increase the temperature of the air. There is a hot gas or hot liquid flow in those pipes and we use fins to increase the surface area for heat transfer. On the right side you see a typical example from electronics. There are many times we want to keep the temperature of the component at acceptable level. And in those cases, this kind of fins are typically used to increase the heat transfer. As I already mentioned, the basic idea of fins is to increase surface area for heat transfer. We know that the heat flux from the surface is a heat flux coefficient times the surface area times the temperature difference between our body and environment. But how effective is our extra surface area? That's something we want to know. Let's make an energy balance for a fin. On the right you see a fin which is connected to base material and we will take a small slot of the fin and for that slot we can write that the heat conduction coming to that small slot is the conductivity of the material times the temperature difference times the cross-sectional area. And the cross-sectional area is the fin width times the fin thickness. And the heat conduction out from that slot is heat conductivity times temperature difference times this cross-sectional area. But now we must take this temperature derivative at location x plus dx. There is also heat flux from the slot to environment. And that is the convective heat transfer coefficient times the surface area times the temperature difference between this slot and environment. And this surface area is now the perimeter of the slot times this dx, and the perimeter is 2 times the width of the slot plus 2 times the thickness of the slot. Now we can write that the heat conduction coming from the base material is the same as heat conduction out from that slot plus heat flux to the environment. And after some mathematical processing we will get an equation from which we can calculate the temperature of the fin. There is this second derivative of temperature and that temperature itself. But we know from basic mathematics that this equation can be solved by integrating. Typically this equation is shown in a bit different form. If we take into use new variables, theta, which is the temperature of the slot minus temperature of the environment, the constant m squared, we can write this equation in this form. And in open literature, this energy balance is typically shown in this form. Here is the solution for our thin temperature distribution. But please don't get shocked now, this looks more dangerous than this is. The reason is that we don't need all these solutions. There are now solutions for different tip conditions. Tip means this end of our fin. The first solution is for case when we take into account the convection at tip. The second one is for adiabatic tip. And then there are solutions also for prescribed temperatures at tip and for infinite fin. Typically the thickness of the fin is very very small compared to length of the fin. And this means that it's not a big error if we neglect the heat transfer from the tip. So we can use the simplest solution, which was for insulated tip. And there is still one more method to take into account the effect of the tip. If we have a rectangular fin, we can add half of the thickness of the fin. And if we have a pin fin, we can add one quarter of the diameter. I made an example calculation to see the effect of the tip conditions. In this case, we have a base temperature 80 degrees C and the length of the fin is 50 millimeters. And there are three different tip conditions. We have adiabatic tip, convective tip, and this adiabatic tip plus extended length. Seems that the temperature profile of the fin is almost exactly the same. So we can use this adiabatic tip condition and use this extended length. When we are working with fin design, we quite often meet some terms which can be very confused. These are fin efficiency and fin effectiveness. With fin effectiveness, we compare the situations with fins and without fins. For example, heat transfer from a pipe without fins, compared to situation when we have fins. Fin efficiency is a measure how well our fin is working. If the thermal conductivity of our fin material would be infinite, in that case the whole fin would be at the same temperature as our base material. And for that case, we say that the fin efficiency is 100%. But in actual practice, the material thermal conductivities are much lower. If we have aluminium or copper fins, the typical efficiency is in range 0.8 or 0.99. But for steel fins, this efficiency is typically 0.6, maximum 0.8. In this picture we have an example calculation of fin efficiency. This was calculated for pin fin having diameter 1 mm. On y-axis we have fin efficiency and on x-axis we have fin length. And the materials here were aluminium, copper and steel. And If we look at this table, we can see that, for example, if we take this aluminium, the effect of this convection heat transfer coefficient is quite remarkable. So not only this fin design, but also this convection is very important. Let's take one more example. I sent a request to chatGPT to develop a Python code to calculate heat transfer in electronic cooling case. I described I want that the temperature of the base material is maximum 85 degrees C, and I described the dimensions and material was aluminium and a lot of other things. You can read the detailed description here. And what I got from ChatGPT was a very good description how it understood my task. And then it gave this Python code, and using that Python code I calculated the case, and it was giving many plots and this kind of table to analyze the results. And for example, here we see a plot maximum ship power as a function of inlet cooling temperature. And this was calculated using a convective heat transfer coefficient 100 watts per square meter Kelvin. And in this next one we see the maximum ship power as a function of this heat transfer coefficient. Here this heat transfer coefficient is from 20 to 100 watts per square meter Kelvin. And on y-axis we have this maximum power. Here is a function of fin efficiency as a function of heat transfer coefficient. And because the material was aluminium, these fin efficiency values are in a typical range for aluminium. Then I sent a similar request, but asked to use pin fins. I described that the pin diameter should be 1 mm, pin length 15 mm, and the total number of pins 225. I request that the maximum base temperature must be below 85 degrees C. And it gave me back a very nice description of this problem and this Python code. And this Python code was also giving very, very nice plots of the results. The table to analyze the results. For example, here we can see the ship maximum power as a function of cooling inlet temperature. In this case, the convective heat transfer coefficient was 100. Here, in the next one, we can see the maximum power as a function of heat transfer coefficient. And here the pin efficiency, the material was the same as for rectangular fins, it was aluminium. Okay, these were the results, and what I want to point out that when you design this kind of cooling elements, it's not only the design of those fins, but you need to take care of that convective heat transfer, because those fins are creating some pressure loss for airflow. It easily creates a situation that your cooling air will bypass the cooling unit. Be very careful when you locate your fan. Okay, if you want to learn more how to calculate fin heat transfer, there is a lot of very good material in net. For example, here is a link to one very good publication. Okay, that was all today. Thank you and see you again. Bye bye.